Have you discovered that you can 3D print with us at the Deerfield Library, but have no idea where to even begin? I'm Zach, and I'll be showing you exactly what you need to get started. So there's only really one thing that you need, that being what's called an STL file. Each one of these files is comprised by a series of two-dimensional triangles that connect with each other to form three-dimensional objects. Utilizing specialized 3D printing applications known as slicing software, we're able to take these 3D objects and, as the name suggests, slice them into many different horizontal layers, which are then fed to the 3D printer as movement instructions. As the 3D printer reads this file, it uses a specific combination of motions to extrude softened plastic filament out of what's called a hot end. By doing this at very exact rates, the printer will layer by layer build up a 3D model in its entirety from bottom to top. So, where do you find these supposed STL files? Fortunately, it's easier than hunting for buried treasure. Your first option is finding an already existing file on a website such as Thingiverse or printables.com. These are public communities where creators can upload their own content that anyone can download for free. This is a great starting point if you don't have any experience with creating 3D models yourself. Your other option is to get your hands wet with trying to create a 3D model on your own. While a wide range of software exists that can aid you in this process, some can be more complicated than others, and a lot of people generally take their first steps on a website called Tinkercad. This is a free-to-use, user-friendly 3D modeling application that you can use online without needing to download any additional software. You simply make an account, and you can start modeling. The best part is that all of your projects are stored on your account, meaning that you can access any of your work on any computer simply by logging in. There are also many fantastic tutorials incorporated into Tinkercad itself, meaning you don't even have to leave the website to start learning. It's a great jumping-off point if you've already found things on Thingiverse or Printables to submit, and feel like you're ready to try creating something new. So let's first walk through the process of finding something on Thingiverse and how to both download that object as well as submit it to us on the Deerfield Public Library website. We're first going to visit Thingiverse proper, which will immediately upon arrival begin showing you some of the more popular files that have been uploaded recently. While something may catch your eye right away, I'm going to look up something more specific. We're going to go and find what's known as the 3D Benchy, a cute little boat that becomes synonymous with your very first 3D print. We simply click on the object to bring up the details page, which will be where we both find information on the file itself as well as find download links for the STLs. We want to click on Files, which will display a range of different files available. As some designs will be comprised of several different objects, you'll need to download all of them to have what you need to create what you see in the display images. However, for our Benchy, we just need to download the file called 3dbenchy.stl. After our download finishes, all we need to do is submit it using the 3D print submission form on the Deerfield Library website. We're going to go to deerfieldlibrary.org/makerspace, or click on the Makerspace button on the library main page. After that, click on the Submit a 3D Print button, which will take you to the 3D print submission form. Simply fill out each field with the appropriate information, and attach your file using the File Upload button. We're going to find our file in the Downloads folder. Click on the file and hit Open, which will attach it to the submission form. Also keep in mind that our form cannot accept 3D print files that are larger than 25 megabytes. We're also happy to show you some different methods of reducing a file size if you come into the Makerspace. Once the file is attached, simply provide a brief description of your file, and check the I would like to have my model scaled to be 50 grams of filament box if you want your file to be free. Go ahead and click Submit, which will send over your submission. Great job! Your file should be headed our way, and we'll send you an email when your 3D print submission is completed and ready to be picked up. That's it for today, and we'll see you in the next video.